So at EHA this year, I was presenting an update of the so-called MAIA study. The presentation was mostly pre-specified overall survival analysis of the MAIA study. As you know, the study is now quite well known. It has been published in the New England Journal in 2019 for the primary analysis. The study, as we know, is a large phase 3 international study for registration in transplant-ineligible patients at the time of diagnosis. The control arm was lenalidomide on low-dose dexamethasone, as approved in many countries. And the investigational arm was lenalidomide dexamethasone in combination with daratumumab. So both arms given to progression. So this is something important. So this is continuous therapy in the elderly. The median follow-up is now approximately 56 months. And the primary endpoint, as usual, is progression-free survival, with all other secondary endpoints, and overall survival is, of course, a key secondary endpoint. So just going back to efficacy and before discussing overall survival, just a few additional words on PFS. There is a great PFS benefit in favor of daratumumab in combination with lenalidomide and dexamethasone versus lenalidomide and dexamethasone alone. The median PFS for the control arm had already been reached at 34 months, approximately. The median PFS has not been reached yet in the daratumumab, lenalidomide and dexamethasone arm, but we are close to the median. The 60 months PFS is 52.5%. Which means that the median PFS will be around 5 years. I think it's important to highlight this because it's clearly a new benchmark for PFS in the elderly. The best regimens we had so far have provided median PFS around 3 years, just to make it short, with either the combination of lenalidomide, bortezomib, and dexamethasone, so the so-called VRD, or the combination of daratumumab with bortezomib and melphalan, so the so-called DARA-VMP regimen. So we basically, this regimen has moved the PFS from 3 years to 5 years. And this is, from my point of view, a very good news for patients. Then this PFS benefit translated into a survival benefit. And the median survival has not been reached in either arm, but there is a statistically significant benefit in favor of DRD. The 5 year OS rate in the DRD arm is 66% approximately. So at 5 year, 2/3 of patients are still alive. So it's difficult to speculate on what will be the median OS in this kind of population, because in the MAIA study, you have, for example, you have 44% of patients with an age between 75 and 90. So that's a very elderly population. So patients may die from something else. So it's difficult to speculate, and we should not speculate too much. But I would say we may expect median OS with DRD probably between 6.5 and 7 years, and this will be a great achievement as well. So these efficacy results were achieved at the expense of a very manageable toxicity. We got a little bit more neutropenia in the daratumumab arm. Grade 3-4 neutropenia was approximately 30 versus approximately 50%, mostly grade 3, in fact. And we got some increase, a moderate increase in infections, including pneumonia. So this was already known from the primary analysis. So we did not see any additional, any new safety concerns with this update analysis, with a median follow-up, which is now approximately a little bit less than 5 years. So safety is fine, very manageable. Efficacy is great. So we at the end, we have a new standard of care for transplant ineligible patients. And these, as I said before, these nice results have been achieved in a very challenging population. with more than 40% of patients having an age over 75 years. So this is definitely a new standard of care for the elderly. And you might say this is the new standard of care for the elderly, to be honest. And of course, nothing is perfect. So the study has limitations, as all studies, but it's a nice regimen. My final comment would be to say that, as we all know, daratumumab has now switched from IV to sub-Q. And in the MAIA study as well, recently some patients have been allowed to switch from IV to sub-Q. So this regimen will be even more attractive, even more easy to deliver in the elderly with the use of subcutaneous daratumumab.